Slim crowd, must be the weather today. 4.5 inches of snow. I think 3 in 2 hours, someone said. Great weekend. Kids did an awesome job. It started with our preparation. You know, I was really anxious to see how we would respond after our Evansville trip. I thought our preparation was good. But the thing that I was even more impressed with is we found out about an hour before game time on Friday that Hannah would not be playing. And our kids didn't miss a beat. They took the challenge. One of the keys going into the game was our guards were going to have to really rebound for us. Our attention to detail on the defensive end was tremendous. And one of the things that we talked about is offensively, we have to get back in transition, make them play in the half court. We have to keep the rebounding battle close, and then we have to take care of the basketball. And we did all of those things and did them extremely well. We had 4 kids in double figures. Steph Davison led us with 21, I believe. But our attention to detail on the defensive end against a very athletic Missouri State team was really what allowed us to win that game and win it the way we did, especially without Hannah. This team continues to really just persevere. It's hard when you find out an hour before that you're losing a starter and your leading rebounder. But again, you have to give them credit for embracing and really, really following the game plan and excelling in the game plan. We knew coming in that Missouri State was going to be out for a little revenge. We beat them at their place. They came in. We were tied. It was very important that we come out and we be the aggressor. And again, I thought our kids did that and found a way to win. We wasn't satisfied with that. You know, I got asked yesterday after the Wichita State game, what was the turnaround after getting beat by 33 points at their place? And I think what you have to understand with this team is we have a short memory. It's not about what it's done in the past, it's about the present. And this team really, really embraced the fact that we had a great opportunity in playing a very, very good team, a team that had won 20 games in a row, had not lost in the league, and had arguably the best player in the league. Again, on a one-day prep, we knew coming in that the game was going to be won. They out-rebounded us 50-something to 21 at their place. We had to keep the rebounding battle close, or we had to win it. And the key to the game was we started, we played fearlessly. We threw punches, and kept throwing them. But the key was we held them to one offensive rebound in the first half. Again, defensively, our attention to detail was outstanding. Our offensive execution was good. We took care of the basketball, and that's a team that pressures for 40 minutes. We took care of the basketball and did some really good things going into half. We were up 18, they cut it to 7. You don't win 20 games in a row and know that they're not going to come back. They came back second half, they cut it to 4. And what I really liked about our team is we never panicked. We continued to handle their pressure, continued to execute offensively, and found a way to win. But you could see it in this team's eyes. They knew they had a chance to win this basketball game, and they executed beautifully. And it started again with their preparation and practice last week. But we had 4 kids in double figures. Brooke Brown was tremendous. We asked her to guard Harden, which again, she's probably going to be Defensive Player of the Year and MVP of the league. She had 31, but they were a tough 31. I thought we did a good job of really making her make tough shots and really trying to wear her down. Brittany Donaldson played the point for us. She was phenomenal. Not only did she have 22 points, but the thing that I really liked about her is she did a great job of controlling the tempo. To have 22 points, 4 assists, and no turnovers in 32 minutes against that pressure speaks highly of that kid. But we had 4 kids in double figures. She led us with 22. Jen Kaito was outstanding on both ends of the floor. She had 19. Brooke Brown, again, I can't say enough about her. She had 17. And Amber Sorensen came off the bench and gave us a huge lift in the first half and had 12. But the game was won. We won the turnover battle. We had 15 points off of turnovers to their 10. One of the emphasis, again, coming in was rebounding. We had to be able to limit them to one and done, and to hold that team to 10 second chance points is tremendous. And then we won the bench points, and we held them to no points in transition. So it was a great weekend for us. It was the third opportunity for us to get ourselves into second place because Indiana State did get beat yesterday, so it made it even a little sweeter. You know, our rule is we celebrate till midnight. I'm sure our kids did that. I know we did that as a staff. And back to work again this morning in terms of watching film. Our kids will have the day off. And then we have to get ourselves ready for a tough road trip at Loyola and at Bradley. Both Loyola plays a matchup zone, and Bradley plays some zone. And both teams are very good offensively. They like to push the basketball. And Bradley plays five guards. So it's going to be a tall task for us, but we'll go to work in terms of our preparation tomorrow. Are there any questions?
Tony, good